गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, माई नेम इज़ डॉक्टर वी विजय शेखर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस डेप्थ अबाउट डेंटल इम्प्लांट मटीरियल्स. आउटलाइन हिस्ट्री ऑफ डेंटल इम्प्लांट्स, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ इम्प्लांट्स, इम्प्लांट कॉम्पोनेंट्स, क्लिनिकल सक्सेस ऑफ डेंटल इम्प्लांट्स, इम्प्लांट मटीरियल्स, सेलेक्टिंग एंड इम्प्लांट मटीरियल्स, बायो कंपैटिबिलिटी ऑफ इम्प्लांट्स, बायो मैकेनिक्स, समर. The key words are replantation, implantation, transplantation. Replantation is reinsertion of tooth back into its socket soon after intentional extraction or accidental removal. Implantation, process of grafting or inserting a material which has an inert foreign body, alloplast or tissue within the body. Transplantation, the transfer of a body part from one site to another. Biointegration, the process in which bone or living tissues becomes integrated with an implanted materials which no intervening space. Osseointegration, the process in which living bony tissues forms within the implant surface without any intervening fibrous connective tissue. Coming to the implant, any object or material such as alloplastic substance or other tissues which are partially or completely inserted or grafted into body for therapeutic, diagnostic, prosthetic or experimental purpose according to the GPT-8. This is a glossary of prosthodontics. Dental implant, a prosthetic device or alloplastic material implanted into oral tissues beneath the mucosal or periosteal tissues and on or within the bone to provide retention and support for the friction or removal process. As shown in the diagrams, we can go through them, the periodontium, bone abutment and the junction between the bone and implant surface is considered to be the osseointegration, implant body, abutment and crown process. The difference between the natural tooth and dental implants to diagrammatic presentation. Coming to the natural tooth, we come across enamel, dentin, pulp, gum tissues, periodontal ligament, root. These are the basics which we know. When we come to the dental implants, the custom-made crown, abutment, implant, allular bone. The difference between the implants and natural teeth. Natural teeth and implant. Roots are made of cementum and dentin in natural teeth. In implant, made of titanium with a textured surface. Ovoid in cross-section. In implants, round in cross-section. Connection to bone by periodontal ligament. In implants, the direct connection to bone by osseointegration. Connective tissue attachment to cementum. No connective tissue attachment is seen in the implant. The gingival fiber run perpendicular to the tooth surface. As in implants, the gingival fibers are circular. The classification of dental implants is based on five things: implant design, mechanism of attachment, design of microscopic body, surface of implant and material used. The classification is based on the implant design depending upon their placement: endosteal, supraosteal, transosteal, intramucosal, ramus frame, root form and blade form. Coming in detail about endosteal implants, which are most commonly used, they are made up of metallic, ceramic or polymeric material and are available in form of blade, screw or pin. This is most commonly used and safer method than any other method. Endosteal, root form, ramus form, blade form as seen in the diagram. Subperiosteal, it consists of framework that rests on the bony ridge of the jaws. Transosteal, it penetrates completely through the mandible. epithelial, it is inserted into oral mucosa. Mucosa was used as an attachment site for metal inserts placed into acrylic denture. The mechanism of attachment is basically mainly on osseointegration and fibrointegration. Osseointegration is a process in which the implant is placed in this mechanism. There is a contact between bone and a loaded implant surface. By this process, one can replace from single tooth to all the tooth on the upper and lower jaw. Fibrointegration, periodontal fibers. In this process, there is encapsulation of implant with the soft surface. In this process, the abutment is attached immediately after the placement of implant. Classification based on attachment of mechanism is osseointegration and fibrointegration, that is periodontal fibers. The here we clearly we seen in the diagram, in the case of osseointegration, the bonding between the implant surface and the bone is clearly seen, and there is a perfect success of implant is based upon the osseointegration. When it come to the fibrointegration, is a pseudo formation. I mean the junction of bone and implant. There is a pseudo connection, that is we call as fibrointegration, which is considered as a failure of implant placement. Implant body design, depending upon the design, it has a cylindrical thread, plateau, perforated, solid, hollow dental implants. The classification based on macroscopic body design of implant, it is cylindrical, threaded, plateau, perforated, solid, hollow or vented. The surface of implant is classified into smooth, machined, textured and coated. The smooth surface implant to prevent the microbial plaque retention, these implants are designed to have very smooth surface. The mechanical machined surface implant to provide support to the bone, these implants are machined or the surface. Textured surface implant, the bondage between the implant and the bone increases the surface roughness of the implant. The coated surface of the implant, the porous coating, the materials used for coating the implants are titanium and hydroxyapatite. The classification is based on the surface of the implant are smooth, machined, textured and coated. The material used, based on the type of material used, dental implants are classified into mechanical implants, ceramic implants, polymeric implants and carbon compounded implants. Classification based on type of implant materials, metallic, ceramic and ceramic coated, polymer, carbon compound as shown in the diagram. Coming in detail about the components of implant as shown in the diagrams A, B and C. A is the implant fixture, B is transmucosal attachment that serves as attachment between the fixture and the actual process. C, the actual process that can be either cemented, screwed or swagged. And coming to the main implant components, first is the main component and second one is accessories. Coming to the components, A is the fixture, B is abutment and C is the suprastructure as shown in the diagram. And second one is accessories, surgical cover screw, gingival former, B prosthetic implant and log and impression post. Coming to the implant fixture, the main part of the implant which is placed in the bone, the implant fixture is the component that is surgically placed into the bone, also called by implant body, can be divided into the following parts: body, crest module and collar. The body may be cylindrical or tapered, cylindrical, smooth or threaded surface. Solid or contain holes or vents allow the bone growth to. A threaded is suitable for the placement. Threads maximize the initial contact with the bone. facilitate dissipation of the stress. The functional surface depends upon threaded pitch. The threaded pitch, which is means this distance between the threads, thread shape, the V-shaped square and buttress. The thread depth, the distance between the most outside thread and the most inside thread. Crest module, the portion of the fixture that provides a connection to the abutment or attachment, offers the resistance to actual occlusal load and aims to provide a precise fitting abutment on the fixture. It consists of a platform and anturation of the features. The implant collar, superior part of the fixture. For submerged implant, it is 0.5 to 1 mm in height. For the non-submerged, it is about 3 to 5 mm. The main purpose is it allows the functional remodeling of the bone, improves the abutment fixture interface, prevents the exposure of surface coating. Abutments. The abutments are the components of the implant system that screw directly into the implant. The abutments eventually support the process in screw retain restoration in as much as they accept the retaining screw of processes. For the cement retain restoration, abutment may be shaped like a conventional crown. You can go through the diagram as shown in the slide. The wall of abutments are usually smooth, polished and straight. The length ranges from 1 to 10 mm. In non-aesthetic areas, 1 to 2 mm of titanium should be allowed to penetrate the soft tissues to maximize the patient's ability to clean the processes. The choice of abutment size depends upon the vertical distance between the fixture base and opposing dentition, the existing cellular depth and the aesthetic requirement in the area being restored. For acceptable appearance, an anterior maxillary crown may be required 2 to 3 mm of subgingival porcelain at the facial gingival margin to create the proper emergence profile, and appearance, whereas the fixtures in the posterior maxilla or mandible may have margin termination at or below the gingival crest. The implant superstructure. This is the process that is fabricated with the support of dental implants. They can be of following types: fixed process, crown, bridges, removable process, overdenture. Coming to the fixed detachable process, hybrid dentures. And we'll stop here. The next is the mechanical properties, biological, physical and chemical. We will continue in the next class.